Hi everyone, my name is Shayna Vila, and today I will be talking to you about, I'm sure you already guessed it, director Stephen Frears' 2000 hit film High Fidelity, starring John Cusack. What immediately caught my attention with this film was the intro, the first scene, because we learn a lot of information in a short amount of time. Right away, we meet Rob. And not only do we meet Rob, we learn of two incredibly important elements of this film. Now, in this first scene, we see those two elements in action.
What came first? Music or the misery?
Did you see it? Or better yet, did you hear it? That's right. This film uses two great movie techniques, or at least I think they're great. For this first scene, we learn right away how important the diegetic elements of this movie are. That is, the music. Now, if you don't know what diegetic means, it just means that not only can we, the audience, hear the music, but so can the characters within the film. The sound source is coming from within the film's world. And for a movie that oftentimes takes place in a record store, this is important. Now, the second important element of this film is the narration. Right away in this first scene, we learn that Rob is miserable. You can just guess that Rob is miserable. I mean, look at the expression on his face. Or just look at this next clip. You can clearly see it in both of them that they are unhappy, but we don't actually need to pay attention to their expressions. You know why? Because of Rob's narration in that first scene. It's a different kind of narration. He's not just doing a voiceover, he's directly talking to us, the audience that is. And this breaking of the fourth wall, and it's not only great for getting quick information, but also an insight into the psyche of the main character's mind. Now, throughout the rest of the movie, we hear the music that the characters love or despise, along with the insane narration style from Rob. The music, it connects the characters. It's all of what Rob is about. It's the whole reason he met Laura in the first place, and the reason he feels miserable now. I mean, what came first, the music or the misery? Was Rob miserable before he met Laura or after? That's what I like most about this film. That fourth wall breaking right away, while Laura is leaving, we get quick information about Rob and his top five breakups. We, the audience, are going through his past experiences and current misery with him. And looking at Rob's fourth wall breaking, we can't help but take a good long look at his character. We learn a lot about Rob. Not only is he miserable, he's a little cynical, he's self-involved, and he's obsessed with getting Laura back. Looking at this scene with Barry, we can see how quick Rob is to dismiss Barry's song choice. And looking again here, right here, we see that Rob doesn't care about his ex-girlfriend. We see that he only cares about this new development that he was the one to break up with her. And, of course, the driving element of this plotline, we see Rob is completely obsessed with winning Laura back. I would say that we do see character development with Rob, and in doing so, we go back to that first idea of how miserable he is. Because, as we learn throughout the rest of the film, Rob has commitment issues. Ultimately, when Rob and Laura get back together, there still is a moment of unclarity with Rob, until he makes that final commitment. He asks Laura if she would ever want to marry him. This acknowledgement of commitment is what finally brings Rob out of his state of misery. Now, originally, I liked the beginning and hated the ending of this movie because I didn't think it really did anything different. Of course, Laura and Rob got back together, which is typically seen in romance films. But looking back, I now find that this isn't some typical romance story. We see real development with Rob, development that wouldn't have been seen if Laura hadn't have broken up with him and he hadn't realized how miserable he was, which led to him becoming a better person, one that wasn't fearful of commitment and knew that what he truly wanted and needed in his life. Now, with all that being said, thanks for listening to this in-depth analysis of High Fidelity.